Hello viewers, welcome to Elimu TV, whereby we are going to learn and experience together. Today we are going to have our biology from 2 lesson 11, whereby your tutor will be Mr. Gerard. We are going to handle the topic on transport in animals under the subtopic the pumping mechanism of the heart. Here we are going to look at how the blood is transported from the legs up to the brains and all over the body. We are going to have the following lesson goals, whereby by the end of the lesson you should be able to describe the pumping mechanism of the heart. So at least let us begin and follow up the lesson. We are now going into the pumping mechanism of the heart itself, whereby we can say for every heartbeat the heart goes through rhythmic contractions, whereby the contractions we call it biologically systole, and the relaxation, which are biologically known as the diastole of the heart muscles. The events, these events are referred to as the cardiac cycle. That is, the systole and the diastole, they are referred to as the cardiac cycle. At the beginning of every cardiac cycle, there is a brief cardiac diastole when the both the atria and the ventricles are relaxed and filled with blood. Remember, we have said that the diastole is the relaxation of the muscles. During the diastole, and the atrioventricular valves are open. Diastole is then followed by atrial systole, whereby when I say the atrial systole, I mean relaxation of the atria or the auricles. And in our diagram, we are able to see the atrial systole, whereby the atrial systole, it means that the atrias or the auricles, they have relaxed. That is, they have contracted. You can see the pulmonary valve, it has closed, while the tricuspid and the bicuspid valve, they are open. This is to allow blood to flow into the ventricles. The aortic and the pulmonary valve, they have closed such that the blood will not flow back. But they have to contract for the blood to go to the ventricles. So as we continue, we have said after the diastole, there is that atrial systole, as we can see from our diagram, a period when the atria contract, pumping blood through the open atrioventricular valves into the ventricles. The ventricles are still relaxed. On filling with blood, the ventricles get into systole. So as you can see from our diagram, the valves, that is the pulmonary and the aortic, they have closed such that now there will be a systole or contraction of the muscles, such that the blood will be pumped into the ventricles. Ventricular systole is when the ventricle walls contract. When the ventricle, in our diagram here we have the atrial diastole. But before we go to the atrial diastole, let us finish up with the systole. A ventricular systole is when the ventricle walls contract. When the ventricle wall contracts, it generates pressure which causes the atrioventricular valves to close, producing the first heart sound, known as the lab sound. The high pressure also causes the semilunar valves to open. The contracting ventricle wall pumps blood out of the heart through the open semilunar valves into the pulmonary artery and aorta. At the end of the ventricular systole, the pressure in the ventricles drops below that of the aorta and the pulmonary artery. To prevent backflow of the blood into the ventricles from the arteries, the semilunar valves close, producing the second heart sound, the dab sound. This marks the end of a cardiac cycle, when the whole heart gets into a brief a cardiac diastole and the cycle starts all over again. So this system is just cyclic. As in, you can see from our diagram, we have the atrial diastole, and we also have the atrial systole, whereby our diagram is a representation of the atrias, whereby the atrias are, we can call them the auricles. But remember, we still have the ventricular systoles and also ventricular diastoles. But in our diagram, we are having the atrios, that is the auricles, systole, whereby the systole, we are seeing that there is the contraction of the muscles. So these muscles, they act such that when the atrial the atria have they are undergoing systole, the ventricles are undergoing diastole. So that is how that is normally how the muscles work. Blood pumps out of the heart into the aorta and onto other arteries flows in form of contraction waves, whereby these waves are known as pulses. The pulses are due to dilation of the arteries. The rhythmic dilation enables arteries to accommodate blood that is at high pressure. The pulse corresponds to the heartbeat and can be felt when large arteries near the skin are placed near a bone, for example at the wrist. The diagram you can see from our screen is the pathway of blood flow through the heart, and before it we can have the heartbeat. So this diagram is just showing that the blood flow from the lungs to the heart, to the auricles, to the ventricles, back to the left auricle, to the left, and outside to the lungs. So they are being represented by numbers. So the numbering is representing how blood flows from the lungs throughout the heart up to the lungs and back again to the heart. You remember we said that we have a double circulatory system in the heart, whereby this means that the blood flows through the heart twice in one complete circulation. So if maybe you did not catch up with that lesson, you can refer to, you can liaise with us so that you get that lesson. So now we want to look at a bit something on the heartbeat, because you can remember that the function of the heart, we have got the heartbeat which initiates the circulation of the blood in the body. So the heart is capable of contracting and relaxing rhythmically without fatigue due to its special muscles called cardiac muscles. The cardiac muscles, I guess we can able to see them from our diagram, the cardiac muscle fibers are interconnected so that waves of contraction can travel throughout the mass of the muscle. The rhythmic contraction of the heart arises from within the heart muscles without nervous stimulation. The heart muscles are therefore said to be myogenic. They are myogenic because they don't get tired. They work day in, day out without them being tired. However, the heartbeat is initiated by the pacemaker, whereby the pacemaker, we can call it the sinoatrial node. This is a small area of specialized cardiac muscle fibers in the wall of right atrium located near the vena cava. If you are able to look at the vena cava, you are able to see the sinoatrial node. The sinoatrial node sends out a wave of excitation to the atrium. These waves of excitation travel towards the septum and into the atrioventricular nerve, whereby the atrioventricular nerve, they can be represented by just AVN, the atrioventricular nerves, and they are discharged down the Purkinje tissues down to the bottom of the heart and then distributed to the ventricles. This causes the ventricles to contract. Although the beating of the heart is initiated by the sinoatrial node, the rate is under nervous control. The vagus nerve slows down the heartbeat, whereas the sympathetic nerve speeds up the heartbeat. In human beings, the normal heart rate is 72 beats per minute, but can vary depending on factors such as age and also health. The heartbeat is monitored using an instrument known as the stethoscope. Having done and said that, we are going to have the following activity whereby we can describe the describe the pumping mechanism of the heart. For further reference, we can have KLB Secondary Biology Students Book 1, 4th edition, Kenya Literature Bureau. And for more information, you can send us an SMS through the number that is appearing on our screen, or you subscribe to our YouTube channel, which is Elimu TV, or you send us a message on our Facebook page, which is Elimu TV, or you tweet us at Elimu TV_Kenya. Thank you.